we will organize the Loops 2014 workshop in Korean Monastery close to Berlin, and it's going to be about closing the loop between societal and environmental dynamics, and we will focus on creating an innovative modeling framework for addressing these important questions. And to advance upon these questions, we've invited several very prominent scientists, and I will mention only two now. One of them is Johan Rockström from the Stockholm Resilience Center, who will talk about planetary boundaries, and the other one is John Schellenhuber from the Potsdam Institute for Climate Impact Research in Potsdam. He will talk about Earth System Analysis, and also, of course, many other prominent people will attend. So the main question is that in the Anthropocene, a strong coupling between societal dynamics and the environmental variability of the overall Earth system has emerged, so that what people do does have an impact on global climate, for example, does have an impact on the global biosphere. And also, on the other hand, what happens in the biosphere has a strong impact on humanity, and this closes a loop. And this has not really been addressed in modeling so far, and but it becomes really important now for several reasons. One is that the United Nations has advanced the Sustainable Development Goals now, and this is actually about achieving development goals such as eradicating poverty and hunger, for example, but at the same time achieving environmental goals and not crossing planetary boundaries that would lead to a collapse of the life support systems of the Earth. So that we have to actually consider these both of these things at the same time, and this is what we want to do with our modeling framework that we want to develop at the workshop. An important example is the interaction between tipping elements in the Earth system and on the societal side. Tipping elements are parts of a dynamic system such as the Earth that are non-linear, and they can undergo a change from one stable state to the other, which can be quite dramatic at some... for example, take the Greenland ice sheet. It is projected to collapse, possibly due to anthropogenic global warming, when a tipping point in the global mean temperature is crossed. And the crossing of this tipping point, the collapse of the ice sheet, would lead to a global sea level rise, which is, by geological standards, quite rapid. And this could in consequence cause societal tipping, such as the breakdown of states, economic crisis. And to understand these processes is really important, because the consequences for humankind would be severe. So we really want to understand these things, first from a conceptual perspective, but then also in detailed quantitative modeling.